Hello dear students, a very warm good morning all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in our previous video of the biology we have discussed about the lithosphere and hydrosphere. So in today's session we are going to discuss about the next layer of the earth, that is we are going to discuss about atmosphere. So what is meant by the atmosphere? As we know, our earth is having the layer of air. And that layer of air is called as what? Atmosphere. That layer of air is called as atmosphere. Our earth is surrounded by a layer of air. That layer of air is called as atmosphere. So after that atmosphere contains the different layers. Okay. The atmosphere contains the different layers. And which are the name of that layers? Like the names are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere and the exosphere. Like that, five layers are present in the atmosphere. So let's discuss one by one which are the layers of the atmosphere. First one we are going to discuss about the troposphere. So the first layer from the earth's surface, it is called as what? Troposphere. So as we know, on the earth the sunlight reaches and it gives us the heat. That is the reason the air which is near to the troposphere is quite hot. Okay, the air which is near to the troposphere is quite hot. And whatever the weather changes takes place, weather phenomenon takes place, that all that takes place in the troposphere. So the weather related changes takes place in the troposphere. Now which are the weather related phenomena? We can say that formation of the cloud, rain, fog, okay, snowfall, all these things are there which takes place in this troposphere. And very important thing is that as we go higher up in the atmosphere, then the air is getting rarer, okay, or the amount of the air is getting decreases, okay. So in the upper part of the troposphere, there is a less amount of the air as compared to the lower part of the troposphere. And that is the reason the aeroplanes and all the planes are moving in the upper layer of the troposphere, okay. So see, there is a rare amount of the air in the upper layer of the troposphere. That is the reason the passengers, those who are travels in the aeroplane, they are having the special. However, because of special facilities are there, in this way they can take the proper amount of the air to do the proper breathing. Okay. So this is about what? Troposphere. Now next one we will move for the next layer of the atmosphere, that is what? Stratosphere. So this stratosphere is very important because in that stratosphere there is a one layer of the gas, and the name of that gas is what? Ozone gas. So this ozone gas help us to absorb the ultraviolet rays which are coming out from the sun. Okay, it avoids the entry of that ultraviolet rays on the earth. Okay, and what happens if there will be no ozone gas? What happens that all the UV rays will reach on the earth surface and it will cause the skin cancer, it will cause the different types of the skin diseases, and it will harm our eyes also. Okay. So in this way, that is the reason this stratosphere is also very important. Next one is the mesosphere. Mesosphere helps us to burn whatever the meteorites are coming out. All these meteorites are getting burned into the mesosphere, and that is the reason that burned meteorites cannot come on the earth surface. After that is the ionosphere. We can say that thermosphere. Okay. So in this ionosphere and the thermosphere, all the shuttle or the space shuttles are moving in this ionosphere or the mesosphere, ionosphere or the thermosphere. And the last one layer of the earth is what? Exosphere. Or the last one layer of the atmosphere is what? Exosphere. It is the outermost layer of the atmosphere. So in this way, there are the different layers of the atmosphere, that are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere and the exosphere. Okay. So all these are the five layers of the atmosphere. After that, just now we have discussed that all the weather changes takes place in this troposphere. In that one is major, a very important factor or the very important weather phenomena, that is nothing but what? Water cycle. So now let's discuss how this water cycle forms, or how the rain forms. How does it rain? So as you know, from your first standard, you are discussing that how is the water cycle takes place. So because of the heat of the sun, the water in the water bodies get evaporated. That water or that water vapors are going up high. Okay, it will go very up high in the sky and it will get cool. When it get cool, it forms the cloud. And in that cloud, again that all the water vapors will get cooled down. Okay, and once it get cools down, means which process takes place? Condensation process takes place. Before condensation, which process takes place? That is what? Evaporation. So after evaporation, condensation process takes place, that is what? Formation of the cloud takes place. Then it started to form the drop of the water. So many drops of the water comes together, then it becomes so much heavy, and then that heavy drops comes, heavy water drops comes down on the earth in the form of rain. Okay, so in this way we are getting the water cycle. Once it forms the rain, then it goes into different water bodies. It spread into the different water bodies, and again that water we can get in the lake, river, sea and ocean, and different small streams of the water. Okay, so this is about what? Water cycle. And now next one we will discuss about what? Biosphere. The biosphere. So as we know, what is meant by the biosphere? First of all, we have discussed the living organisms which are present in the lithosphere, hydrosphere and the atmosphere are called as what? Biosphere. So this biosphere is so much vast. There is a so much big variety we can see in the biosphere. Biosphere is spread in the lithosphere, hydrosphere and the atmosphere also. So as you know, the earth is a very big planet. There are so much diversity on the presence or the presence of the things on the earth. We can see the big mountains, rivers, different water bodies we can see. Also we can see that different regions, some regions doesn't have that much water, some regions are having the throughout the year rainfall, that we can call as what? Desert regions are there, which is very hot, and they are having so much sandy soil over it. Some regions are having the so much plants are there. Okay, after that some regions are having very cold climatic conditions, some regions are having very hot climatic conditions. Also we can find out the, we can get the salty water in the sea or the ocean. Also we will get the fresh water in the lakes, rivers, wells, etc, etc. Okay, so in this way there is a lot of variety present on the earth. But along with this lot of variety, presence of the lot of variety on the earth, in that lot of variety also we can get the biosphere. We can also get the biosphere. So there is a drastic variety, or there is a so much diversity in the plants and animals which are present on the earth. So as we know that, have you know kangaroo? Yes, so that kangaroo, also we can say the penguins. Okay, all these are the animals, those who can find out only in that particular area. For example, we can say that what? Kangaroo can get it only in the Australia. Okay, also next one, penguin we can see in the polar regions. So in this way there are the certain animals that we can get in that particular places only. Lion, tigers are living in the hot areas, or we can say that what? They are living in the grassland. Okay, afterwards we can see the lot of variety of the fish. Some fish are living in the ocean, some fish are living in the fresh water. Along with these animals and plants, okay, along with these animals and plants, there are some microorganisms are also present on the earth. Okay, along with that microorganisms, we can get the different varieties of the plant. Along with the region, the plants are also different. For example, we can say that if we talk about the desert, then which plants comes in your mind? Yes, you are correct, that is what? Desert. Okay, so the different region contains the different plant. If we talk about the underground plants or the underwater plants, then we can say water hyacinth is there, lotus is there, that is what? Floating plants. Like that we can get the variety in the terrestrial plant also and in the aquatic plant also. Okay, so this earth is having the different variety of the living organisms. They are having different animals, plants. Along with that, they are having the organisms also, microorganisms also, and all that things are there, comes under this biosphere. And this biosphere we can get in air, water and in land also. Okay, so this is all about what? Biosphere. So today we have discussed about atmosphere, we have discussed about the water cycle, how we get the rain, also we have discussed about the biosphere. Okay, so my dear student, this is all about today. Here we have completed this lesson. What is the name of the lesson? The Earth and its Living World. Okay, so here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.